Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we're looking at creating clipping masks in Photoshop. Now I'm going to be using some Design Cuts assets in this video, so let's have a look and see what I'll be using. First up, I'm going to be using a couple of fonts. The first one is Montana font family, and the second one is Sunshine and Daisies font, and that has a lot of different elements in that font. I'm also going to be using some Photoshop shapes, and inside this hand-drawn illustration pack of 550 plus hand-drawn illustrations are some Photoshop shapes, so I'm going to be using those. And finally, I'm going to be using some high-res photos from our 100 high-res photos collection, and there's some just awesome images in this collection. So that's what I'm going to be using, so let's head now to Photoshop and have a look at creating clipping masks. I've already opened the first image that we're going to work with, and in the layers palette you'll see that there's just a background layer, which I'm going to unlock. If you can't unlock it by just clicking on the lock icon, then double click on the layer and that will unlock it. Now I'm going to use a shape for this clipping mask, so I'm going to the shapes collection. I'm going to select the custom shape tool, and I've already installed the shapes from the shapes collection. So the one I'm looking for right now is this cloud shape. So I'm just going to click on the shape to select it. I'm going to make sure that I'm working as a shape. There are options here for paths and pixels, but I'm going to make this a shape. So I'll drag over to create my cloud. And to move it into position, I'm just holding the space bar as I move it. And when I get it in position, I'll just let go. Now it's filling with black. Right now it doesn't matter what color it fills with, because we're not going to be seeing the black at all in just a minute. Now there are also some raindrops in that collection. I think they'll work really well with this image as well. So I'm going back to the shapes tool. This time I'm going to grab the raindrops, and there are a couple of sets of raindrops. I'm going to grab this lot and then just draw in the raindrops here. And again, just make sure that I place them in position. Now this gives me two layers, and when you go to create a clipping mask, you need one layer to clip to. So we're going to need to put these two shapes on the one layer, if you like. So that's possible in Photoshop by selecting both of the shapes layers. Click on the first one, shift click on the second one. Right click and you can choose merge shapes, and what that does is it creates a single shape layer with these two shapes on it. So we've just got one layer that we can use as our clipping mask. Now the concept of a clipping mask is that we're going to take a portion of the image, the photograph, the shape of the clouds, and we have to reverse the order for this. So we're going to put the photograph on top and the clouds on the bottom. And then we tell Photoshop that we want to clip this photograph to the shape of the cloud. And we can do that a couple of ways. One way is to just click on the topmost layer and choose Layer, Create Clipping Mask. And that creates your mask. Now I'm just going to undo that because there's another way. You can hold the Alt and Control keys on a PC, that's Command and Option on a Mac, and just hover between these two layers, and you'll see this little icon, this square with a bent arrow beside it. Click it once, and that also creates that clipping mask. And you'll see that the photograph has been indented here. That tells you that there's a clipping going on. And there's a little bent arrow here. Now, if you want to get things back out, you'll just go to Layer, Release Clipping Mask, or you can come back to the Layers palette here, hover between these two layers, again holding Alt and Control on a PC, that's Command and Option on a Mac, and just click again, and that releases the mask. Now, I'm going to put my mask into position. Because once you've cut a shape out of an image, you're left with, what am I going to do with the rest of it? Well, of course, you could just export this as a PNG image, and that would maintain the transparency, and you might want to use that, for example, on a website. But you might also want to put a white background or a colored background behind this, or at least have a look and see what it's going to look like if you save it as a JPEG, because if you save it as a JPEG, it's going to get a white background. So let's see how we would do that. I'm going to add a new layer. So let me just go down to the layers palette here. I'll control click to add a new layer. Now it went in the middle there, it's fine. I'll just move it to the bottom. So you can always just drag your layer, your empty layer, to wherever you want it to be. White is my background color, so in this case I'll press Control Backspace. That would be Command Delete on the Mac. and then we've replaced the transparency at the bottom of the image with actual white. And of course, we could change that to another color. We could sample a color from the image, for example, and use that instead. So let me just go and get a blue from the image. It's the foreground color. I've got the layer selected, Alt Backspace, Option Delete, and that would give us a blue background. Now I'm just going to undo that because I want to show you something else. If you like this effect, but you think that you might like to see an outline around the shape, then this is what you're going to do. You'll click here on the shape layer, because if you're going to add a stroke outline as an effect, you're going to be doing it to the shape layer. So we'll click here on FX and click stroke. And this will allow us to add a stroke around the edge. Now, in this case, I am going to sample this blue color. I'm going to use that as my stroke, and then you can set the stroke to the outside or the center or the inside. You can also adjust its opacity and its size. I'm just going to leave it as it is and click OK. So there is one example of using a clipping mask. Here we've done it to a shape. It could just as easily have been pixels, but I chose to make it a shape just to show you that you can actually use a shape, and that's fully editable. That shape can be edited using the paths panel. You'll just click on the shape. Here is the shape in the paths panel, and you've got all your shape tools available to you. And these all have anchor points and nodes, just like any shape in Photoshop, and they can be adjusted. So there's our first sample. We'll have a look now at another example. For our second example, I've already opened the image, and this time we're going to use text. So I'll click on the type tool and I'm going to select a font, and I'm going to use the Montana font. And I'll just type the range. Now the Montana font comes in three styles, so I'm going to use the roughen one, which is a little bit of a rough edge sort of font. Again, it doesn't matter what the color is, because that's going to be lost when we make it into a clipping mask. At this stage, I can adjust the font. For example, I might want to close the letters up a little bit. So let's go to the type tool here and let's just close the letters up a little bit. For this effect, when you're using a text object, you'll want fairly big letters, so you'll want a font that is fairly thick, and you'll also want the letters to be pretty close together so you can get enough of the image behind in the resulting piece of text, because what we're going to do is cut out the photograph to the shape of the letters. Now I'm also going to close up these two letters, the E and the space, and so I can come in here and close them up a little bit further still. Just so we don't have really, really big spaces here in our text, it would be better to have more text and less space. Now I don't have to get everything in position yet, because it's going to be fully editable in a minute. Let's go to the layers palette. I'll unlock this layer and then reverse the order of the layers, because you need to have the object that you're clipping to on the very bottom. Let's this time create our clipping mask using the menu. So I'll choose layer, create clipping mask. And now I can adjust things. I could adjust the photograph and I can adjust the text. So I'm going to the photograph, and with the move tool selected, I'm just going to move the photograph so that I can put the horses where I want them to be. And I could also enlarge the photograph if I needed to, just to make sure that I could position the horses within the letter and making sure that I haven't moved the photograph out of the area that I'm working. Now you can also edit the text, because the text remains fully editable. So you can come back here to the text layer and select the characters and make an edit to them. I'm not going to do that right now. Now for this one, the same as the other one, we may want to put a layer behind just to see how everything's going to look. So I'll click on the bottommost layer, hold the Control or Command key on a Mac, click on the new layer icon. White is my background color, Control Backspace, Command Delete to fill it with white. And of course, I could fill it with another color should I want to. I can also add a stroke around the text should I wish to. I'll go to the text layer, go to the FX icon, go to stroke. We're still using the stroke that we had previously. Let's go and select a color from the image itself. And we could adjust the position. In this case, I like to put mine on the inside so it doesn't make the text any thicker than it was, and just click OK. And of course, that's an editable effect. You can remove it or apply it by just clicking on the eyeball icon here. Now, should you be working on a larger graphic, you may want to lock these two layers down so that they travel together. You can select both of them and click the link icon, and that links the two layers. So if you go and move one of the layers, you're going to move both of them in tandem. They're going together. And that can be useful when you're working inside a larger project with these elements. For this last example, I'm not going to actually do it. I'm just going to show you how it was put together because it shows how you can use multiple layers with a clipping mask and how you can use multiple layers as a clipping mask. So I started off with this photograph here, and then I opened a second photograph, this one here. Now I really liked the sky here and I wanted to borrow this sky. So quite simply what I did was put one image on top of the other, and then I just added a mask to the topmost image. I added a small gradient to it, so it's running from black to white, and that just poked a hole in the top image, if you like, so that we could see the sky from the one underneath it. So I've got two layers that I want to apply a clipping mask to. And then I created the shape that I was going to use as a clipping mask. In this case, it's a shape. It could be just fill pixels. That's fine too. It's a shape from that collection that I showed you earlier. Now I'm going to move the shape underneath the photos, and we'll create our clipping mask using both layers. So I'll do it with the bottommost layer and then do it with the topmost layer. And both of those are inset, so they're being clipped to the shape of this envelope. Now I also wanted to add some text across the bottom, so let's have a look at the text object. I'm just going to move it up to the top here. Now this is from the font that I showed you earlier, the Sunshine Daisies font, and I wanted to clip the font also to the images. Now you can only have one object that you clip to, and we saw earlier when we merged two shapes together to make a single clipping object. But here text and a shape are two different things. So what I did was I created a group. And if I put the shape and the text in a group and then use that as the clipping object, then it's going to work just fine. So let me put my shape in the group. Let me go and get my text and put that in there too, and then go and recreate my clipping mask. So now we have two layers of image clipped to what are two layers of objects. One is a piece of text and one is a shape. And because they're inside a group, you can see that they're inside that group, then they can be used collectively as a clipping mask. And of course, we can also apply a stroke. Now, in this case, I've applied the stroke to the actual group, so everything is nicely stroked. And I've added just a white layer underneath. So here we have an example of multiple images being clipped to what is effectively a single shape, because we've put multiple shapes into a group and Photoshop is treating them as a single clipping object. The effects that you're creating with clipping masks could of course be created with masks themselves, but sometimes it's just easier to create a clipping mask and have the ability to move things around very easily, and in some cases the ability also to edit your text even while the clipping mask is in place. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Photoshop techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.